While notions like digital black markets and non-national currencies may have seemed futuristic only a few years ago, today, peer-to-peer anonymous exchanges like Bitcoin is allowing is pioneering an entirely new way for the global community to think about financial systems.
The idea behind Bitcoins was to digitally replicate gold, kind of a gold standard for the internet.
The idea of a decentralized currency is important because it removes those levers of power that people can exploit to corrupt a currency.
Well, Bitcoin is the world's first completely decentralized digital currency. That's what's unique about Bitcoin. It is, for the first time, a way for the two of us to exchange value online without a third-party intermediary. Until the invention of Bitcoin, for you and me to exchange money online, we had to employ a third party, like PayPal, like Visa, like MasterCard.
Bitcoin's value is at an all-time high again. Its market cap is now twice what it was at the 2011 peak. It is nowhere near its potential, Rick Falkring says, which is four orders of magnitude above today's value. This is where the quantitative easing is flooding in. The Dow hit an all-time high. The very same day, Bitcoin, the unmanipulated free market of Bitcoin, hit an all-time high, $46.
Bitcoins are booming. The price of one unit of the digital currency jumped during the past few weeks from about $40 to nearly $150.
That is bigger than many expected, so if you're looking for a safe haven, Deirdre, you might want to start considering virtual cash.
The value of each Bitcoin hit a new high this week. As of right now, it's around $450. That is the value of one Bitcoin.
What people don't see in the background is hundreds and hundreds of startups that have significant innovation that are being invested in by mainstream investors and that are creating thousands of jobs right now. So Bitcoin is a little island of growth and jobs and opportunity and innovation.
It is a form of internet cash, a virtual currency that can be traded online, and Bitcoin has been taking off.
Some guy just transferred $6.5 million using Bitcoins, and it cost him 6 cents. Now the PayPal fee, that would be $188,500. If he'd done it over a bank wire, it would have been over $250,000.
The Washington Post quoted experts calling Bitcoin the holy grail. Astonishingly secure, anonymous, invisible to the tax man, it could soon rival the dollar.
It's the first time that we have actually a currency which is not controlled by any central bank or any central party. The real criminals are not the people that are using Bitcoin. The real criminals are the guys who are wearing suits and going around Wall Street and every day scamming people.
It's about removing control of wealth from countries and from banks.
All right, Bitcoin is taking the market by storm and causing controversy and uncertainty the world over.
Ron Paul said dollar alternatives like Bitcoin are fantastic. They offer freedom of choice. They're commodities that offer better value than what the Fed is printing.
Fiat money is never going to be stable. It's always going to deteriorate. A Bitcoin is quite a bit different. It's something that's come about in a modern age.
Take our dollar. It's lost 96% of its value since 1913. The Australian dollar, it's fallen 99% over that same period. The Canadian dollar, down 95%. The British pound, off 99%. Warren Buffett recently stated the obvious about all of this. He publicly said people are right to fear paper money, that it's only going to be worth less and less over time. These currencies are dying right in front of us. None of us are blind to what's going on.
It's impossible to be shut down. That's the beautiful thing about it. There is no place, there is no Bitcoin place. You can't shoot Bitcoin.
It's as easy as buying any foreign currency. Transfer in cash and get Bitcoin delivered to your virtual wallet on your laptop or phone.
The value of Bitcoin skyrocketed to a new record of $900 today.
There's just too much money in Bitcoin to have to wait.
The target value for Bitcoin is not some $50 or $100, it is $100,000 to $1 million.
Now we live in the 21st century. If we want to have a video call to China, we can do that for free. But to send a couple $100, which is essentially just ones and zeros being moved around, cost 5%.
The VP of PayPal, Bitcoin, the perfect currency by design, Bill Gates. It's a techno tour de force.
So the great value is that it's a technology that no one person controls. So the banks don't interfere with it, the government doesn't interfere with it. You control your money, you can send it where you want to who you want.
It's not some theoretical concept. It's a billion-dollar market. It's here now. It's working. We're using it.
We have to imagine once it's auto-integrated into every web browser, cell phone, and email, it's almost unfathomable how high Bitcoin could go.